Good morning, students. Today, let us start our revision, and today I'll discuss multiple choice based questions. So let's start. Question number one is, when an object is thrown up, the force of gravity. Now, you see here, when object is thrown up, but G is acting downwards, so force of gravity is number one option, opposite to the direction of motion. Yes, you are seeing object is going upwards but G is acting downwards. Second one is in the same direction. No, it is false. Becomes zero at the highest point. No, at highest point velocity will become zero. And last option, increases as it rises up. No, it is also false. So first one is satisfied. Answer A is right. Come for second one. A change in velocity. When there will be change in velocity? When an unbalanced force acts on it. So let us see. First one, result from inertia. No, it is not satisfied. Second one, requires an unbalanced force. Yes, it requires an unbalanced force. So whenever there is an unbalanced force is applied, there is change in velocity. B is right. But let's see the last two options. Result from a zero net force. No. And last one is the natural state of motion. A change in velocity is not the natural state of motion because you have studied Newton's laws of motion. So B is right. Come for question number 3. Rocket works on the principle of conservation. In rocket, which principle of conservation is applied? First, mass. No. Energy. No. Momentum. Yes, conservation of momentum is applied for rocket in the principle of conservation of momentum. And last, fourth question is, the two states of motion treated alike by the Newton's first law. Among A, B, C, D, conditions are given. Let's see. A is rest. B is uniform motion. C is uniformly accelerated motion. And D is non-uniformly accelerated motion. So out of these four, which one will be correct option for what? The two states of motion. Which are the two states of motion? Inertia of rest as well as inertia of motion. So let us see. First option is A and D. A is rest, but D is non-uniformly accelerated motion. No, because no acceleration here we will get it. B is A and B, means inertia of rest and inertia of uniform motion. So answer B is right. C, A and C. A is rest, but C is accelerated. No, no acceleration will be there. And last option is B, D, that is uniform motion and non-uniform accelerated motion. It is also not correct. And the last question is, while catching a stone thrown by your friend, you pull the hands back too. Whenever we are catching a cricket ball or a stone or a ball, we are just pulling our hands back. Why we are pulling our hands back? I think you are remembering the Newton's second law of motion, that is rate of change in momentum is directly proportional to applied force. When we pulled our hands back, the time increases and change in momentum decreases, and this is directly proportional to force. So force also decreases and we will get less hurt. So let us see the options. First one, avoid getting hurt. Yes, we can say this one. Second one, B, increase the time to slow down. Yes, B will be the correct answer. Increase the time to slow down. As time increases, change in momentum decreases. So, option B is the right answer. C, decrease the time to slow down. No, it is wrong answer. Avoid the breaking of stone. No sense of last word. So answer B is right for question number 5. Okay.